I need to know how. Are you real serious about surrendering all? Are you real sincere about that? You see, it's one thing to sing a song, but it's another thing to actually do the song. And I believe that the time is now for us to surrender. Surrender all unto Jesus. The time is now. The urgency of this hour is before us. I believe that God is speaking to our hearts in reference to being serious about our relationship. Serious about our relationship. Serious about our relationship. And as that happens, something is going to happen inside of you. Something is going to happen. There's going to be awakening inside of you that's going to cause you to go places that you have never gone. That's going to cause you to do things that you have never done. It's going to drive from inside. It's going to drive you from the inside. And you'll be asking God, what is it that you want me to do? I'm willing. Are you one of those that are willing? No, I'm not talking about just going through in excitement, but willing to say to Jesus, Lord, I am ready to go forward. I don't want to just sing that, but I'm ready to go forward. I'm ready to tread on turf that I've never walked on before. I'm ready. I don't know what's beyond, but I don't care. As long as you're with me, I will go. That attitude, that's the attitude that God's calling for. That's the attitude that God's calling for. And I'm ready for this. I'm ready for this. I just don't want the regular anymore.
Amen. Jesus.
High test for me.
Yeah.
Jesus. High test. I don't want regular.
Amen.
I don't want the norm. I want radicalism.
Amen.
Yeah.
Are you hearing? Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah. Praise God.
Yeah. Let's go somewhere we have never been. Let's do something we have never done. Let's look for something that we have never seen. And I'm telling you, as you move into the Spirit of God, you're going to see things over there that you never saw over here in the natural. I'm telling you. You see, God has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. That's the Word of God. He has conveyed us. He has delivered us out of the power of darkness.
Yes.
Yeah.
And conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love. Now, wait a minute. If I'm not going to see any more in the kingdom than I saw over there in darkness, then what's the use? If I'm not going to do any more now that I've been conveyed into God's kingdom than I did when I was over there in darkness, then what's the use? If I'm not going to see any more now that I'm in the kingdom of Jesus than I did when I was over there in darkness, then what's the use? Are you hearing what God is saying? I'm telling you, the time is now.
Now.
I've got eyes to see that I've never seen with before. I've got ears to hear that I've never heard with before. I have a desire to experience that which I've never experienced before.
Praise God.
Amen.
There's something here that you haven't seen before. Uh-huh. You're in the kingdom. You're in the kingdom. You won't deny that. You've been delivered out of darkness.
Yeah. Right. Amen.
You won't deny that.
Praise God.
But then, bless God, let's do business like we've never done business before. I'm not just the norm is just regular or no, I'm not, no. Radicalism. Remember the word of dread that God gave unto us? Aggressive.
Aggressive.
That's the word.
Praise God.
That's the word. How aggressive are you? Is it just, you know, just normal for you? Do you have a sense? Are you experiencing a sense of?
Yes.
See, that has to come from you. It has to come out of you. It has to come out.
Yeah.
You know, I can encourage you. I can exalt you. I can talk to you. But it has to happen in you.
Amen.
I'm going for it. I'm going for it. I'm going for it. I know there is more for me than what I have. I know there is more of God than what I have. I know there is more of the kingdom. There's more. There is more. Because the kingdom of God, the nature of God's kingdom is increase. More and more. And this is not something that you're going to generate on human effort. Don't even think like that. This is not something you got to go home and say, well, I'm going to try to do. No, it don't work like that.
Right.
Amen.
All God wants from you is a yes. That's all he wants from you.
Amen.
All he wants from you is a yes. Because, see, he has the master plan.
Yes, he does.
And you don't even know what it is.
That's right.
But you got to be willing to go.
Amen.
Did you hear what God said? And Isaiah responded. He said, who will go for me? He said, I'll go. And then I see where the eyes of the Lord runs to and fro throughout the whole earth.
Yes.
To show himself strong in the behalf of those whose heart is perfect toward him. God's looking for somebody like you. God is looking for somebody like you. He is looking for somebody like you that'll say yes.
Amen.
He is looking for somebody like you that'll say yes and without you know, not asking what the price. I don't care what the price is. I don't care what price has to be paid. The Apostle Paul got a hold to it. He says, I count no longer my life dear to me. But all I want to do is to finish my course. All I want to do is to run this race. Finish my course. I don't even count my life dear to me anymore. Don't bother. Don't break my heart about telling me what they're going to do to me. I don't care what they're going to do to me.
Amen.
You get a hold of that?
Yeah.
See, I'm not making this up, you know.
Praise God.
Do you care what happened to you? You got to lose. You got to get a good case of that. I don't care.
Amen.
If you still timid and you know, and worried about your big toe, well, you're not qualified. I don't care. But they go, I don't care.
Praise God.
But I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm going it. I'm going. I'm
yes.
going for this. I'm going for this.
Amen.
I'm going for this. I'm going for this. And that's the attitude. That's the attitude. That's the attitude.
Amen.
That's the attitude. That's the attitude that now I'm you know, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's the attitude that God wants from us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have to say yes to him. You have to say.
Amen.
You know, if you ever in a place and you think, well, I'm okay. You no, oh Lord. You don't know how bad off you are. If you ever say I'm okay,
yeah.
You don't know how bad off you are.
Yeah.
I'm not okay.
Amen.
I want more.
Amen.
Yes,
amen. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
I want more.
Amen.
I want more. I don't know how to get it. Well, God said, just raise your hand. I'll show you how to get it. I'll give it to you.
Amen.
Yeah. I'll show you. I all I'm looking for is willing vessels. I'm not looking for you to know anything. I know you don't know anything.
Right.
But I know everything.
Praise God.
But I just need you to, this is an all volunteer army.
Amen.
All volunteer. You know, when a soldier enters into the military, he don't know anything. But when he volunteered, then they'll start training him.
Amen.
And they'll teach him. Well, that's what God does.
Yes, he does.
So you don't think, you know, I got to know something, I got to be this. No, 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 no. The less you are, the better off you are. God will train you.
Amen.
To suit what he has for you to do. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So don't get this laid back attitude like, I got it, man. No, you don't. No, this laid back attitude, I got this. You don't got this. You need this.
Amen.
You need this. And I want to encourage you because that's what I'm, you know, God's pushing me and I'm pushing you. I'm going to push you. I'm gonna push you. I'm gonna drive you. Yeah, you get mad and tired. Well, just jump off. Somebody else will take your place. Don't worry about it.
Right.
It's always been that way.
Yeah.
People that quit, God always has somebody take their place.
Right.
Yeah. So I'm not worried about it. I don't worry about people quitting.
Right.
Yeah. See, I've had them quit before. Yeah. They jump off and let nothing jump on. You probably took somebody's place.
Yeah.
This thing is real. This ain't no joke.
That's right.
This is real. This journey is real. It's real.
Amen.
Now I'm excited about it. I want to be all I can be. I want to do all I can be because the time is short. You know, the time is short. I don't have a lot of time here. We don't. You know, if you stay here 120 years, that's nothing. So we don't have a lot of time to get this done. So bless God, let's just maximize the time while we're here. What do you say? What do you say? Let's just maximize our time. Let's do this thing. Let's go at it. You know, thank God got past that touchy stuff. Bless God got past that all that foolishness. You know, all that whatever it was. I don't know. Been out of that so long, I forgot what it was like. And I couldn't stand for nobody to say anything ugly to me about me. You remember those days? Remember those days when you get bent out of shape for somebody that said something ugly about you?
Yeah.
Remember those days when you get all bent out of shape for somebody that told a lie on you? Remember those days? Bless God, those days. Aren't you glad those days are over?
Praise God.
Amen.
Aren't you glad you have no grudges against nobody?
Praise God.
Oh, glory. Isn't this wonderful?
Yes.
I'm a forgiver. I'm kind. I'm affectionate. I'm tenderhearted.
Amen.
Remember those days when your heart was hard?
Yeah.
Remember that? Hallelujah. Now I got a tender heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, it's time to go forward, you know.
Amen.
Tenderhearted. Yeah, forgiving one another.
Yeah.
Isn't this wonderful life when you have aught against no man?
No.
Amen.
Got aught against no man.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Glory
to God. Hallelujah. Yeah. Glory to God.
Yeah.
Thank you, my
Lord. Glory to God. Got aught against nobody.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Good thing.
Boy, this is good company. Good company.
Yeah.
Good company. This is good company. Amen. Amen. Praise God forevermore. Yes. Yes. Turn over to Deuteronomy chapter number 30. Deuteronomy chapter 30. Praise God forevermore.
Yes.
Deuteronomy chapter 30. I'm very proud of this group here. I really am. You are the nucleus. You're the nucleus. You're the one. You're the spearheaders.
Amen.
You're the ones that's out front.
Praise God.
Yeah, yeah. You're the real ones.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You're the ones I can depend on.
Amen. Yes.
You're the one God can depend on.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Be encouraged. Be encouraged.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Deuteronomy chapter 30. I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you, that I've set before you life and death, blessing and cursing.
Amen.
Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you do that? How do you choose life? What does that mean? How do you do that? Now, this, if you think about this, this statement here is for every breathing being on the planet.
Amen.
Think about that. God set life before every man. John 3:16, God so loved the world. The world. Uh-huh. Not just in North America, South America, but the world.
Yeah.
That he gave his only son, only begotten son, that whoever believe on him should not perish. I've never seen anybody that wanted to perish. Everybody wants life, but they're going at it the wrong way. How do you embrace this life? And what does it all mean? How? Because when I looked at this and I thought about how simple this was, and you know, God said, I got witnesses that I've done this. And I thought, God, you don't need no witness. I said, you just say it and that's good enough. I said, really, you don't need to be swearing and all that. But he does, because he really wants us to understand, I want you to have this.
Praise God.
I said, all you got to do is just say it.
Amen.
Yeah. And can't nobody, dispute your word? Can't nobody.
Right.
You don't really have to swear by this.
Amen.
And you don't need no witnesses.
Right.
But he wants, what do you see here? You see God's heart.
Amen.
I believe if people knew how much God loved them, it would do something for them.
Yeah. That's right.
God, one place, he said, I don't want not one person to fail.
Right.
Not one to perish. But I would that all men come to repentance.
Amen.
I love the whole world. The Jesus hanging on that cross is a picture of God's love for the whole world.
Amen.
Wow.
Praise
wow.
God.
Wow.
Wow. Thank you, Lord.
You say, God loved me? Yes.
Yes.
He loved you. God so loved the world. And then he brings you all that he has. He brings you all of his inheritance, all that he owns, and lays it before you. And said, this is yours.
Yes.
And it ain't no gimmick. There's no gimmick. There is no gimmick. You know, we've lived, you know, we've been hoodwinked by the devil so long, we think there's a gimmick behind everything.
Right.
You know, when you offer somebody something to you, what's the catch?
That's true.
Fooling with the devil so long. You fool with him, it's a catch with him. I'll show you that. When you fool with him. But with God, there is no catch.
Amen.
That's why he won't sell you anything. He'll give you all he has.
Amen.
God will give you all he has, but he won't sell you anything.
Amen.
And there is no catch to it.
Amen.
You say, what's the motivation behind that? His love.
Praise God.
God is love.
Yes.
You don't know what love is. You know, we throw the word around so carelessly. We don't even know. It loses its punch. You know, I love apple pie. What?
Right.
That's good, Beth.
Right.
Pie don't even qualify to be in the arena.
Amen.
But we're so careless with the word love, we don't even know what it means. And so once the devil robbed its value from us, we just throw it around all in the world, got it out there just throwing it around.
Right.
Making love. What? In the middle of sin. Dear Lord, they don't even know. But the devil got just so careless with the word and what he does. It robs us of its value.
Right.
Then you don't even realize when God tells you he is loved. You don't even know what, don't even mean a thing to you. Because the word love has just been so carelessly used around you. You, what? God loves me? Has no punch to it. Because you don't know what it means. But you need to listen, stop and listen. And God said, when you look at all that God is and look at the world and the all that, look at the universe and all of his creation. Everything that he made, heaven and earth, the universe. And it is so synchronized. It's so in order. The universe, just the universe itself is so in order. Why? Because it's governed by love.
Amen.
That's why the earth never crashes into another planet. That's why the ocean, it rushes to the shore and it turns around and it goes back and it won't even swallow you up. Why does it do that? If you look at the earth, it's a ball hanging out seemingly in the middle of nowhere. And I'm walking around on the thing and I don't even fall off. Why? Because love placed me here.
Right.
Love is the greatest of all. God is love.
Praise God.
Amen.
And sin messed us up, and so God is, the process here is the redemption process, and God restoring us and bringing us back into an order where we can really have some fun.
Amen.
See, you don't know nothing yet. You haven't seen anything yet. The Bible says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have entered into the hearts of men the things that God has prepared for those that love him.
Amen.
But he has revealed it unto us by his Spirit. The only way you can have any inkling of this is by the Spirit of the living God. Wow. You haven't seen anything. I was meditating on some of these things today and talking to the Lord about these things. I'm thinking, like, dear God, can we hurry up? Wow. He said, just chill out, son. Chill out. Just chill out. You know. Man, we are into something. And here's what it is. When you begin to understand this, and we're going to get to this in a minute, when we begin to understand and begin to comprehend this journey, stuff's going to wake you up. That's what's going to motivate you. That's what's going to prod you forward. Mm-hmm. That's what's going to lock you in. That's what's going to make you talk like the Apostle Paul talked. That's what's going to make you talk like Jesus. When you begin to understand who you are and understand the love of God.
Yes.
See. Now, God said, I've set this life before you. Now look at what he says. I have set life before you. Okay, a good question. What do you want me to do with it? That's a valid question. I want you to live it.
Live it, yeah.
That's a no-brainer.
Amen.
Watch this. That's what it says there. That or so that both you and your descendants may live.
Yeah,
yes.
I said choose life so that you and your descendants, the life that's on you is going to roll over on your descendants and they're going to live to the power of this life.
Amen.
Dear God, do you know why you have embraced life? Because somebody before you loved you. Somebody loved you. And I'm talking about somebody on this planet loved you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now God's loving you. That's without question. But somebody on this planet loved you. The reason that you know about this life right now, somebody on this planet loved you.
Amen.
Enough to tell you.
You
know, you got to be the biggest fool in the world to fight against this world, fight against the word of God. You got to be absolutely a nut.
Amen.
Not knowing what you're fighting against. Somebody loved you, and you know what you know. And God said, I'm setting this before you. Take hold to it, and not just you going to live, but your descendants. Is going to have the knowledge of me.
Uh-huh.
Now, in my experience, I have no knowledge of not never knowing Jesus, about Jesus. I have no knowledge of that. The first public place I ever remember going was church.
Amen.
Now I realize everybody's not in that particular boat, but that's my experience. So the love that I, so somebody, my parent loved me enough. They loved me And I'm their descendant. And the life is now on me.
Amen.
Well, that's what God said.
That's right.
My parent received this life. And now their descendant is alive. I have this life. My descendants is alive.
Amen.
See how this works? And it just goes from generation to generation. But not only so, but now as we operate in this life, we pour it out and it goes out from us. That's what I'm doing now, sharing this life. That's what I'm doing now. Because everybody wasn't like me. Everybody didn't come up in an environment like me. But yet God loved you enough, even though you did not come up in an environment like that, God loved you enough to put you in the way so that you can still catch hold to it. Dear God, that's good.
Hallelujah.
I've talked to people that love Jesus and was loved, wonderful believers, and their parent was nuts. They didn't get anything from the parent. But God had somebody in the way to pour out on them. See, I'm trying to show you the love of God. So he said, I'm setting this before you. Choose life that both you and your descendants may live. Now, when you choose this life, this life accesses the hidden treasures of the wisdom of God. When you embrace the life of God, you embrace the hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge. And this is what causes you to excel. That's what we was talking earlier tonight when I said, you know, you don't have to know anything. Just say yes to God. And when you say yes to him, you're saying yes to life. And you are going to be connected to the hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge of God. Amen. That's what's going to cause you to excel. I'm so excited. You remember they said to Jesus, they said, I don't know. Why do you think you know so much? You never even went to school, in essence.
Yeah.
He said, the knowledge I have didn't come, in essence, didn't come from books.
Right.
Amen.
It's from my Father.
Amen.
Yeah. Now, the devil will tell you, the world tells you that it all gets, you get all, if you don't get it from the books, you don't have it. Well, they don't know anything.
That's right.
See, this is so vital to understand the life of God. This is not religion.
That's right.
Notice what the devil does. He'll take our relationship with Jesus and he throws it in that big pile of religion and calls it, that one is yours, this one is yours, this one is yours. As long as everybody got one, everybody's fine. One of the biggest lies ever come out of hell. And people believe that.
Yeah.
To the point where Christians are afraid to even witness. Because they're afraid the repercussion that's going to come back and say, well, what makes you think your religion is right?
Right.
But begin with, Mac, I don't have religion.
Right.
Amen. Got Jesus, if you will. In fact, I make it a note. I make it a note when I'm witnessing to people, when I'm out all the time, mouth going. I make it a note. I don't talk about religion.
Amen.
I talk about Jesus and I talk about this life. Because religion is not impressive to people.
Amen.
Because you got some crazy wild religion. Well, that's not there. Everybody got some of that. But we talk about Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I want you to do. I want you to understand that Jesus is who you want to talk about. I want you to understand that Jesus is who you want to exalt. I went back and I was reading back through the book of Colossians and I began to look at it and all I was seeing was Jesus being exalted.
Amen.
That's all I'm like, wow. You know, you see what you're looking for.
Yeah.
I'm looking at this, I'm reading it, and all I see is Jesus being exalted. And Jesus and we're being told who we are and what we have, and Jesus is the reason for it.
Wow.
Read it all the way through, and that's all you're going to find.
Amen.
Yes.
Dear Lord, I say, I can do this. I like reading this.
Yeah.
And so, when we're talking about being aggressive in our carrying this gospel, don't worry about religion. Tell people about this wonderful life that you are living.
Amen.
And this wonderful Jesus that's responsible for this life that I'm living.
Amen.
That's what you want. See, people don't care about your religion. You got religion. Religion over there killing people.
Right.
You got religious nuts over there cutting people's heads off.
That's right.
That's their religion.
Right.
Well, I don't want to identify with that.
That's right.
I identify with Jesus.
Amen.
And do not, listen to me real good, do not be ashamed of the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's evident that you have this life when you are not ashamed of Jesus Christ. I'm not ashamed of Christ.
Amen.
Jesus is the Christ.
Yes.
He is my Lord.
Yes.
And I don't make any bones about it.
God.
And he is the only one that they're afraid of. They're not scared of your religion. Your religion don't bother them.
Right.
Your religion don't bother the devil.
That's right.
But Jesus just gives him heartburn. he can't do that. He can't do Jesus.
Yeah.
And that's who I am. That's who's coming with me.
Amen.
And if Jesus can't come, I can't come. And that's right now as I speak, this, yet your own nation, your own countrymen detest you when you call on the name of Jesus. And they are trying to remove his name from every obla, every station, everywhere. They want to remove it. I don't care. You can even say, God, don't say Jesus. Right there, you should smell a rat.
Amen.
Don't say Jesus. Now, don't talk about that. Well, the devil been saying that for years. He sold that to the apostles. He told the apostles, ooh, don't preach in the name of Jesus. Ooh. Why are they so afraid of the name of Jesus? Because that name is above every name.
That's right.
Amen.
God has exalted Jesus and given him a name which is above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
And that's not going to change. And you need to be on that side. You do not need to be on the opposite side of Jesus. You need to be on the side with Jesus.
Amen.
And you're going to have, see, if you don't keep yourself stirred up, you will go out and you'll be quiet. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I know. I know. You'll be out and it'll seem so thick. That you don't want to, I don't want to stir anything up. Listen, honey, it was stirred up when I got here. And all I'm going to do is make it worse. They don't like you. Oh, of course they want to. They told you to come to lunch with them, but they don't like you. The world do not like you if you in love with Jesus.
That's right.
Jesus already said they hated you and they hated me and they're going to hate you too.
Yeah,
so don't even try to pretend that they like you. They don't like you.
That's right.
So don't try to just keep it quiet.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to be just as bold as I can. Yeah, you invited me out for lunch. Bless God, let's pray over this grub. You want to impose your religion? No, I want to impose. I got to qualify this food to eat.
Amen. Praise God.
You don't want to pray, then just go ahead and jump into it like a pig and go to eating. I'm going to pray over this grub I'm about to eat. And I'm not ashamed to do that.
Amen.
Did you know I have blessed people in public by praying over my food?
Amen.
It's amazing. I've gotten comments from people that whoa. I have in restaurants.
Right.
I don't care where I'm at. And you better pray. You're in that restaurant, you better pray over that thing.
Amen. Amen.
You don't know. You don't know what's going on back in that kitchen.
That's right.
I gotta eat this. I gotta eat this stuff, Ralph.
Yeah.
No, that's my witness.
Amen.
Jesus said, pray over that thing.
Yeah.
Give thanks.
Amen.
It is sanctified by the word of God and prayer and thanksgiving. My food is sanctified by the word of God and prayer. So even if they've been messing around with it in that kitchen, bless God, when I finish with it, it's sanctified.
Yes. Amen.
And you should not be ashamed
Amen.
To do that.
Praise God.
That's your witness. Jesus is your Lord. He said, if you're ashamed of me before this mess here, this generation, I'll be ashamed of you before my Father and the holy angels. You don't want that. Notice he said he's gonna be ashamed even before the angels. He's not even gonna mention you before the angels. That's tight.
Yeah, it is.
You think, well, why do the angels need to know about me? Okay, when you die, who you think gonna come pick you up?
That's right.
You don't know where to go.
Yeah.
You might end up anywhere.
Yeah.
The angels are coming to pick you up.
Amen.
But wait a minute. Yeah. Jesus never mentioned anything to them about you. What?
They didn't get the invitation
to come pick you up.
Right.
They didn't get the memo. Didn't you know you're supposed to? Jesus never said nothing to me.
Right.
So now you dead. And ain't got no ride. And you can't wait around to catch a ride with somebody else.
That's right.
Because it's all. So you got to have your own chariot,
Amen.
Your own angel. God shared with me. He shared with me a vision once about that. But angel, and I saw the angel. Came to pick up this fellow. Yeah. But that's true. That's real. So he said, don't be ashamed of me. So what am I saying? What is it going to make me not be ashamed? When I make a decision to receive life, when I make a choice to say yes to Jesus,
yes.
When I make a choice to say yes and I go forward in that, there's something going to happen on the inside of you. The Holy Spirit will fill you, hallelujah,
yes,
empower you. To do whatever
Amen.
God called you to do.
Amen.
This stuff I'm talking is not something you're going to do in the flesh.
Oh, that's
right.
If it's up to you, you wouldn't say anything about Jesus if it's up to your flesh.
Right.
You would ever say anything. Dear Lord. But when the power of God is inside of you,
Amen.
You get a good case of the I don't care. I know who I am, and I know whose I am. I love Jesus with all my heart, and I do not apologize.
Amen. That's right.
You get that way. As a result of receiving this life, God loved you so much that he said, I set life before you. Now, death is out there, too. Notice he said, both of them are sitting there. I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life. I call this an open book test. You can only fail this by being mean. You know the right answer. You know the right choice. You know, multiple choice. And God cheats for you. He points to the right answer.
Amen.
See, that's multiple choice. Any way you look at it here, this is multiple choice here.
Yeah.
You have a choice, and God does not take your choice away from you. You can choose death, and a lot of people do. And the thing about it, they choose death, and they don't realize they're choosing it. They choose death, but expect life. How are you going to do that? If you buy a Ford, you're not going to drive a Chevrolet. They choose death, but they want life. It's not going to happen. I'm talking about good people. Church-going people.